The story of Christmas is one whose roots are planted in the creation of the universe, and whose implications reach forward into ageless eternity. And if any would hope to grasp its beauty and power and weight, it must be told like all true stories. From the beginning. Before the halls of time were formed, before any star had given light, there was God. And it was He who spoke the universe into being. It was He who commanded dry ground to rise from the infant oceans. And it was His word that called the continents up from their shadowed depths. But then, all of creation held its breath. God Himself came down to the planet He had made, and with His own hands He reached into the dust and began to form a new creature. One who would be capable of knowing his Maker in a way no other being could. Man. God saw all that He had made, and it was very good. And God set His love on the man and his wife, and He placed them in dominion over all the earth, that they should enjoy it, and Him for all their days. They would be the father and mother of all who would follow. And like any parents, Adam and Eve held the fate of their children in their hands. But all was not well in the infant universe. The poison of pride was stirring, and Lucifer, one of the greatest and most beautiful angels, rebelled against the Lord and was cast from heaven. Enraged, Lucifer took the form of a serpent and brought the disease of his pride to the unspoiled earth. If he cannot rule over God, he would rule over those who were created in God's image. Adam and Eve chose to side with the serpent. They turned their backs on God and chose to trust and love created things more than their Creator. And so, sin entered the world. What had been life was choked out under a veil of death. But even in that hour, God was working out His purposes. There would be a Savior, and He would be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace, and He would save the world from their sins. But not yet. The children of Adam and Eve carried the chains of their first parents' rebellion and the pollution of their sin. The human race had become one enslaved to its own selfish passions, ignorant of the one in whose image they were formed, the only one who could give them the joy they searched for so desperately. God sent prophets to remind them of the promise he had made to send a savior. But even the prophets wondered, how long, O God? How long until you come and set right all that sin has destroyed? But God was silent. And some began to wonder if he had forgotten his people and abandoned them to the slavery of their sins. God had not forgotten, and the time had finally come to unveil his chosen one, the Savior of all creation. Heaven watched in stunned silence as the Son of God, filled with grace and love beyond measure, took on the form of a human being, a child named Jesus, who would absorb in his own body the poison of humanity's sin. Creator, God came to take the sins of mankind and the chains of their rebellion on himself and to die under the just punishment that we deserved. And so on that first Christmas night, the Son of God, whose hands had formed the galaxies, clung to his mother's dress as he waited silently to bring his people back to their God. A 1,000 years ago, Jesus Christ, the Promised One, did come to this earth. He died under the punishment that we deserved and tore off the chains of our sin. And through his death, he opened the floodgates of forgiveness and fellowship with God. But the story does not end there. For the one who spoke life into being cannot be held captive by death. The question remains, if the Savior has come, why is our world still so broken?
I knew there may have been another impact. Can you tell? I just heard another very loud bang.
This is the other tower, ladies and gentlemen.
Another 3 days, record high oil prices, more troubles in the housing sector, as well as disappointing corporate earnings.
Blood-soaked sand were left in the streets as police count dozens of bodies.
We we do not yet live in a perfect world, it is still racked by pain, hatred, grief, and fear. But all is not lost. The Savior has not failed. There is still one prophecy that has yet to be fulfilled, one that is just as relevant in the 21st century as it was in the first. And they will see the Son of Man coming on the clouds of power. And at the dawning of that day, all that is wrong will be made right, and all that is broken will be healed. And all the works of men will be tested by the one for whom all things exist. And the blind will see, and the lame will walk, and darkness will be banished from the face of the earth forever. And those whose hope and trust has been in Him will see the long night of sin pass away and will come face to face with the One who is their eternal joy, never to be apart from Him again. For the former things have passed away. Behold, He will make